فاطمة رضي الله عنها وأرضاها إلى أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه فقالت: من يرثك؟ فقال: أهلي وولدي. فقالت: ما لي لا أرث أبي؟ قال أبو بكر رضي الله عنه: سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: لا نورث، ولكني أعول من كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعوله، وأنفق على من كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ينفق عليه.
أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه said سيدتنا فاطمة رضي الله عنها came to سيدنا أبو بكر رضي الله عنه and asked who will inherit from you. He replied, my wife and children. She asked, then why is it that I cannot inherit from my father? Sayyidina Abu Bakar radiallahu anhu replied, I heard Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, no one inherit from us. However, I shall provide for those whom Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would provide for and spend on those whom Messenger of Allah would spend upon.
Naam. So Sayyidina Fatima came to Sayyidina Abu Bakr because she was not giving anything from the land. There is a land he left. So she came and she never knew about the hadith which Sayyidina Abu Bakr, about the hadith which just now mentioned about the land, what why never get inherit. So she said to him, she start with a simple way to reach to the point. No need to go, you know, who am I? You know, like this. No. She just said to him, Ya Abu Bakr, who will inherit from you? She said, my family. That family. She said, then, why I cannot inherit from my father? Why I didn't get anything? So Sayyidina Abu Bakr sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to her, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no one inherits from us. نحن معاشر الأنبياء لا نورث. We are the prophets, never give inherit to anyone. يعني properties, they will need no properties for them to leave for the people after them. Because they will leave behind them, if they left family, this family, the best of the human beings, they have no greed in their hearts. And they will not be like other people. If that father were very wealthy, they will wait for him to die as soon as possible. As soon as possible. So they inherit and they will fight after his passing away. And Ahlul Bayt radiallahu anhum, and the wife of Sayyidina Mustafa, wife of Sayyidina Rasulullah, they are not like anyone. They're different. Ya Nisa al-Nabi, for example, لَسْتُنَّ كَحَدٍ مِّنَ النِّسَاءِ. You are not like any other woman. Huh? They're different. Any other woman, first of all, they are أُمُّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُكُمْ. The wives are the mothers of believers. So it's impossible someone to marry her, أعوذ بالله, his mother. Number two, they are there as long as they are alive, they will receive their nafqa. So there is other land which, you know, that will they have a nafqa. We'll go through it now, where they used to receive nafqa as long as they are alive. The minute passed away, that's it. Halas. And this is something for them to just to survive. No need for them to take from others. In Quran, there are two types belongs to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, something for him to get. One they call humus, and other one al-fay. Al-fay is like after Khaybar, there were lands being given, so he got one of the lands for him. This is an instruction by Allah's order, small land. الخمس whatever anything spoils of the war he will get one fifth. صلى الله عليه وسلم. And what he used to do, he used to give it away. Because when he passed away, he never left a single, no dirhams, nothing. Because the people who live, if they know the value of the life, no one will take anything with him. Say, Ya Hajji, you are now in Sakarat. Take this $100 with you. Maybe in your journey you will need it. Well, if you give him the whole world, you give him the, what do you call, certificate, this is the whole world for you, nothing. Because he is not. Once, they were أحد الصحابة, if I'm not mistaken, سالم بن عمر, سيدنا سالم بن عمر رضي الله عنه, بن الخطاب. The ruler saw him in Haram doing tawaf. So he came to him. He said, Ya Salim, he was happy to see Salim, son of Umar and Sahabi. Ya Salim, please ask me if you want anything. He said, Are you serious? I am around Kaabatullah, asking Allah, you want to ask someone else? No. Will you do that? He said, No. He said, How come you tell me like that? He said, Then after tawaf. After you finish your umrah. So when I finished, he came to him. So he said to him, ask me for whatever you want. He said, long life. He said, that's not in my hand. Healthy life, not in my hand. Like this, not in my hand. He said, that's what you have. You have nothing. So I just asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, and he is enough. Allah, so يعني أليس الله بكاف عبده. Allah is sufficient. Is enough for his servant. So when someone leave, يعني he will understand. Subhanallah al-maut wallah. Is a yaqeen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship Allah till al-yaqeen. What is al-yaqeen? Allah call al-maut yaqeen. Because everyone will see it. No doubt. You can't see your rizq while you are before it's come. You can't see anything. But al-maut, you see people leaving and you will, when you pass it, you yaqeen. You will see the angels, you will see sakratul maut, you see everything, you will see all. وَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. Everything. You now, through your eyes, you will see what others cannot see. That's how. That's why he said, prepare for death. But the best, ulama said, prepare for after death. But for us, normal, ordinary people, prepare for death because you have seen people dying. No matter who is he, no matter how powerful, no matter what position he used to have. Alas, he have to be going under, down. No way. So Al-Anbiya, they are different story. Their family, they are different story. Ahlul Bayt, they are different story. They have got from him, I have left behind what he said to the Ummah, two things. The Quran and Ahlul Bayt. In other narration, Sunnah. However, the hadith of Ahlul Bayt is very strong hadith. But saying that Ahlul Bayt, they are the real inheritors of Quran and Sunnah. If they are not going to practice the Sunnah of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and of course the Quran, then who else can do the same more than them? It's not always just to see someone say it's up, say it's up. I go many places in the world, say it's up, on the top of my head, say it's up. But show me your attitude as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said, we know this is Sayyid. From his attitude, from his akhlaq. Yeah. Drink is something simple. You see the akhlaq of Ahlul Bayt al-Kiram رضي الله عنهم. When you read about them, oh, great people. Because they are the example. Why the people write about them? Why the people talk about them in this way? Because they are examples. Say, you are Saadatuna, you are our leaders. Everyone got something. Sahaba got something. They inherit lots of things from Ahlul Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Ahlul Habib, they are the generation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu said, أُرْقُبُوا مُحَمَّدًا فِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِهِ. See Rasulullah through his Ahlul Bayt. So they are very special. They're very special. They have no illness and something about, I want this. There's some people say, oh, you talk about Abu Bakr. Said, you talk about, like some people said, this land belongs to Fatima, Abu Bakr took it. Abu Bakr took it in his pocket. He gave it for Fuqara al-Muslimin. The reward going to Sayyidina Rasulullah. And you think Sayyidina Fatima will be angry with that? Of course, when she know that, you know, Ya Akhi, those people, the story of them, before the food be in their mouth, just going to their mouth, they see faqir, they give it to that faqir. Not someone who will talk, I want this land. They are high, wow, bow from all this nonsense. Because that some people talk about, no, who are you to talk, number one? And you cannot talk about these people because you are nothing. And those people, they need no one to be their lawyer. They have enough. رضي الله عنهم and may Allah grant us barakah of them. Hey. So she said, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I heard that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, no one inherits from us, معاشر الأنبياء, we are the prophets. However, I shall provide for those whom the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم would provide for. And he used to do before, I will still give. No worry about that. You will get always. And spend on those whom Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم would spend on. That won't stop. So your life, Fatima, I mean, don't worry. I am like, I cannot be like your father, but consider me as like your father. And that's how they are very close. I mean, we cannot talk other than that. Yeah? May Allah grant their barakah and their taqwa. طيب. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا نورث ما تركنا فهو صدقة.
عائشة رضي الله عنها relates Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said no one inherits from us the prophets what we leave behind is charity.
Now they have whatever they sorry. As we said earlier, they, you want to leave, or they continue doing something in their life and after their life to be a great example all the time for the people. As-sadaqat is not something you give and go. Al-awqaf, not something you know. Now all the ummah, you can see just something which is very great. How many people they give for the sake of Allah and in the name of Rasulullah every day in the world? Huh? Feeding people. Millions of people. Who taught us this? So Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, let's say no one say he gives fuqara without saying in the name of Allah, in the, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but this is what the ajr, the thawab for Rasulullah. Even if we not say, even no one say, but who taught us Sayyidina Rasulullah? And whoever starts doing something, you follow him, he will get the reward as you. Exactly. من سن سنة حسنة فله أجرها وأجر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة. Huh? So who's taught us to do all these things? As-sadaqat, who's our example in that? Rasulullah. So all the ummah, 1.5 billion, no one in this world got reward of the people who are doing something good in the name of their religion, more than Rasulullah. Right? So any share market in the world go up and down, except Rasulullah's share market is always up. Right? Every day is increase and increase and increase. And no one can be like him. There's no such company in the world can be like that. No one. The companies in one news, khalas, go. Sayyidina Rasulullah, three things. If you do, don't worry, your share market is always up. No decline. صدقة جارية، علم ينتفع به، ولد صالح. Charity, continue charity. علم ينتفع به، ولد. A pious children. And this is what we can see, الحمد لله. Allah's بركة. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يقسم ورثتي دينارا ولا درهما ما تركت بعد نفقة نسائي ومؤونة عاملي فهو صدقة.
أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه relates Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said my heirs will not distribute a single dirham, dinar or dirham. Whatever I have left behind after my maintenance for my wife and the stipend for my agent is charity.
Whatever after him, whatever left, he said, is something which is there generating something as well for his wives and his family. And later, if there's anything that will be for the rulers after me. Yani, like Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman. See, they want them to be the same way. Because the life after that open, it's arm. More things coming, more wealth, but their lifestyle never changed. Same like Rasulullah's lifestyle. Same way he used to sleep, same way everything. Whatever they have given. Like Sayyidina Umar Uthman radiallahu anhu, there is waqf in Mecca and Medina until now waqf Uthman bin Affan. Because they know the value of this life and they know the value of Akhirah. This is Darul Amal. Darul Amal. Darul Fana. This one Darul Baqa. If you will see the success of yourself, not now. You will see it in Akhirah. فَمَنْ أُدْخِلَ النَّارِ فمن أدخل الجنة يعني whoever entered to Jannah he's the one who got the best winner, the first winner. Other than that, whatever you left behind, there's nothing left behind also, unless it's connect you with your creator, with your next world. How many people will pray for you? Wallahi, subhanAllah, I've seen that those very wealthy people, when they leave this world, the one who pray for them, only the poor people. Wealthy people like them, they won't remember them. Billionaire and millionaire. He used to give, one of them, he used to give al-fuqara al-masakin. Other one not. Well, he passed away, that one. What do you say? Allah, ya Allah, forgive my brother so-and-so. For what? Al-fuqara, they say, Allah, so fulan so, ya Allah, rahma. He used to give us, he used to. Ajib. See, that's how. This is what you call the reality of life in simple. You're happy here with what? Why, if somebody say, are you happy? Yes, I'm happy. Why you are happy? I have a house, okay. Children, not good, alhamdulillah. I have my job, excellent. I'm healthy, very well. Wealth. I need these things. In Akhirah, how? Why you are happy now? You cannot say I have house. You cannot say I have children. Your Akhirah, who decide your happiness is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your book, your amal. Open, read. Now we will decide what I'm going to give you, not what you're going to. I am the one who give. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. See that, Ajib. I saw one person once, wallah. I still remember him. Old man came to us. He has a house, about 200 square meter, but in a prime area. In Baghdad. Primary, this is like commercial, very good. So he wrote that house as waqf. to the masjid of Sayyidina Shah Abdul Qadir. That person came. So he said, hey, why you do that? Why you never leave something to your family? He said, I did that because of my family. Why? He said, my children, too greedy, they cannot wait for me to die. They want to poison me. So I die and they take that house. Because I never want to get, I was still in the house, they want to take the house, they want to buy it, sell it, or do some business. So I said, well, let me write the house now, finish. I've seen that, subhanAllah, ajeeb. And those people, they found their way in the world as he made his way. He's a winner now. Left something, alhamdulillah. Allah's barakah. So what Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, see the race, whatever, you know? Sadaqah, I give. Whatever left, give. And he used to do that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Of course, when he used to do something, he give al-fuqara wal-masakeen. You think after he passed away, no one will give them? They will continue giving from what he have left and from what Sayyidina Abu Bakr and others, the khulafa after him, al-Rashideen, they used to give. Alhamdulillah. طيب عن مالك بن أوس بن الحدثان قال دخلت على عمر رضي الله عنه فدخل عليه عبد الرحمن بن عوف وطلحة وسعد وجاء علي والعباس يختصمان فقال له عمر أشهدكم بالذي بإذنه تقوم السماء والأرض أتعلمون أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا نورث ما تركناه صدقة فقالوا اللهم نعم
مالك Ibn Aws, Ibn Al-Hadasani said, I came to visit Umar at his house, radiallahu anhu, and soon after which, Abdul Rahman Ibn Auf, Talha, and Sa'ad, radiallahu anhu, also came to visit him. And then Ali and Abbas, radiallahu anhu, came arguing. Umar asked them, I implore you by the one with those with whose permission, that is, he will, the heavens and the earth subsist. Do you know, Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no one inherits from us. What we leave behind is charity. They replied, oh Allah, certainly we attest.
There is a land which Sayyidina al-Mustafa, this is the land of in Bani Nadir, which left by him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, behind. So Sayyidina Ali and Al-Abbas came to Sayyidina Umar and they have an argument, who is the one who is in charge? And he said, you know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, we are not going to, but I will appoint you to look after, one of you to look after the land. That's in conclusion, which is a long story, but in conclusion, in summary. But one of you to look after, you know, and pay, like you are, let's say, the guardian, right? Mutawalli, call it. And you pay. And so the generation that's the one who got it, Sayyidina Ali. Mm-hmm. And he used to give. After that went to Al-Hassan, then Al-Hussein, then Ali bin Al-Hussein, and then Al-Hassan bin Al-Hassan, and Zayd bin Al-Hassan, and Ubaydullah bin Al-Hassan. Then Abbasin, Banu Al-Abbas, took over that land. But what here they said, there is no other. You will be in charge of it, looking after it, and you will be paid for it. You get your salary for it. Not all, not yours, and you favor others. The favor is Allah and Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The favor, and that's what happened. So as we said, they are different story. Naam. In brief, طيب last hadith عن عائشة قالت ما ترك رضي الله عنها وأرضاها قالت ما ترك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم دينارا ولا درهما ولا شاة ولا بعيرا قال وشكوا في العبد والأمة
عائشة رضي الله عنها said Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم did not leave behind a single dinar nor a dirham nor a sheep or a camel he said and I have doubts regarding a slave man and a slave woman
yeah. So Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not leave behind a single dinar or dirham, nor sheep or camel. which can benefit from it, any animal, cattle, except that old mule called Duldul was given to him by, if I'm not mistaken, either by Al-Qibt, the king of Al-Muqawqas, the king of Qbat in Egypt, or Al-Najashi, the Habasha. I can't recall. One of them, he gave it as a gift to him. Mule, female. And continued after him for some time and died. Yeah. And I have a doubt, the narrator of Hadith said that he got the slave or slave man or slave woman. He never left any slave behind him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has doubt, I say, I'm not sure. Because this is a mana. A mana is what? He don't want to, he's not sure about something, so I'm not sure about this. But of course, the ulama said he have never left behind any slave, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he was anti-slavery, anyway. And it's part of our deen to give freedom, to pay for the freedom of the people. So this is how the Sayyidina Rasulullah's way of life and when the way he prepared himself for the next life. Of course, for all of us, we work very hard to gain something for this life. Not for us. You are not working for you, in fact. You're working for your family. You are busy to arrange something for your family, for their future. All of us. But the best future is, the future is اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. May Allah grant us to be among them. And with their blessings, inshallah. ربنا تقبل منا وقبلنا وارض عنا يا كريم. وإلى حضرة النبي المصطفى سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآل أصحابه أجمعين وعلى آذانهم بسر الفاتحة. صلى الله عليه وسلم الحمد لله تقبل الله منا ومنكم.